All right, welcome in, baseball fans, to the 7th annual Robinson Invitational here at Robinson High School as we have made it to the final game of the day, and this one's between the Wynn Yellow Jackets and the Searcy Lions.
The same rules. When I was pulling their logo last night, because, you know, I'm trying to make sure I'm getting the baseball-specific logos, and it pulled up that up. I'm like, what?
So, swinging the 1-0 pitch is Wynn. Leads off with Gray Westbrook. Shortstop on the mound for Searcy is Michael Lincoln. And Lincoln looking to bring the 1-1 pitch. A little high, 2-1. Pitch on the way from Lincoln. That ball hit right back up the middle, and that'll be a base hit. So leadoff single for Gray Westbrook.
Now batting for the Yellow Jackets, number 9, Kendall Reed.
And now a bat for the Yellow Jackets will be Kendall Reed, the center fielder. So Westbrook. Gets his lead, and that one called a strike on the outside corner. And Will, with this being the last game, I'll be curious to see just how expanded our zone gets in this one. And just like the rest of us, I'm sure our umpires are ready to go.
Yeah, these are the same umpires as the last game. So
that went up and in.
This is the first set of games today that we've had the same umpires today. Yesterday they alternated. First two games, well, not yesterday. When was I here last?
Thursday, yeah.
That's how long it's been.
I know, right? It's been a long 3 days.
Yeah.
You know, I was talking with Coach Delaney between games over there, and we were talking about yesterday's games. He said, yeah, you know, we got like 2 drops of rain over here yesterday. I was like, I know. I was pretty frustrated because I really wanted to be able to broadcast those Catholic games as well as the rest of it, but. As that one gets away from Lincoln. And so that'll push the count to 3-1. But he was telling me, you know, Cabo didn't do Slade Caldwell's home run justice that he hit in that ball game yesterday. Lincoln leaves that one up. Ball 4. So first two runners aboard for the Yellow Jackets. But he was telling me, and obviously this is great for what you can't see on the
on our
broadcast.
You can zoom over there.
I guess so. We'll do it here in just a minute.
Yeah, I'll do it between batters.
But now batting is David Robertson for the Yellow Jackets. Runners get their lead, and there's a strike. So a single and a walk start things off here for the Yellow Jackets. Well, this feels like a game that could be 12-9, somewhere in that range.
I think you've been hoping for that all day, but I don't, because that means the game's going to go long.
I know, trust me.
I want a 2-0, 3-hit game or something like that, where it's an hour and 20-minute game. We got a lot of stuff to pack up. And
there's a strike.
Well,
so Lincoln gets ahead 1-2 here. Robertson, the third baseman. Second baseman trying to sneak behind the runner. Lincoln will bring it to the plate. That one left up, 2-2. This is not a recipe for a fastball game.
No, it's not.
But you know what would be? A double play on this pitch.
Still no outs, though.
It would still help.
Yeah.
Lincoln will bring it. That ball hit
That's not a double play.
Hard left center field. That's going to get down. And they're going to send the runner home. We're going to get a play. Comes in, and he is safe.
No play.
And so Westbrook scores easily. And the first three have reached for the Yellow Jackets. Another single. And now Cy Mars, the first baseman. Lincoln, that went up. 1-0. You want to say thanks to everybody for joining us here over 2 of 3 days of this Invitational. Say big thanks to Coach Delaney for having us out. As that one fouled right back here at us. Hmm? Oh, did you flinch? Oh, man.
I hadn't flinched except that one time.
It was so we got a 1-1 flinch score here. I mean, pretty impressive considering Thursday it was like
everything else.
Everybody was flinching like every single time. Yeah, used to it. You finally trust the net. This
one back.
Up
if we were
to
on the
left.
Side.
Nah, that's out of the park. We're good.
One, two. I like this yelling out the count. Helps me fix it on the scoreboard if I'm wrong.
And one, two. Just a bit up high. Yeah. Count 2-2. Still nobody out.
I've chewed a lot of gum today. Like 9 pieces.
Fourth hitter to bat for Wynn. That one's wide. Well, the count is full at 3-2 to Mars.
Still nobody out. Time to feel like I've seen this before.
Yeah. Except we've had base hits this time. And strike three called as Mars is rung up looking on the outside. Fastball and one away. Now Cooper Thompson, the designated hitter, will bat. So one away. One run in here for the Yellow Jackets. Searcy can get out of it here with a double play. And one on the outside corner for strike one.
On third base, Cameron just went out.
That's strange. Can't be powered.
Oh. Maybe it just got tired of working.
Oh, it's back. It just needed a break. That ball. Down the left field line and foul.
0-2.
I'll say thanks to our Searcy Lion and Wynn Yellow Jacket fans who may be watching right now.
Go ahead and share the stream with all your friends and family that want to watch some good baseball. This Invitational has been elite. There's just been all kinds of talent all over the field, the mound, behind the mound. But let me tell you, the catchers we've seen here at Robinson.
The ball lifted left side. Third baseman calls for it, makes the catch. And there's two away now here in the first.
This has been a well-ran Invitational across four sites and excited to see where it may grow in the future. Hey, it might even double in size. I don't know.
Whew. Yeah. Let's just say that.
It's got a great reputation, though, among, storied baseball programs coming in here and playing some great games against other great teams.
It really does. Runners go, and a chance to get them. Catcher will not take that throw. Great jump, Both runners there, so they'll each advance a base. So now both are in scoring position. Base hit here would make it a 3-0 game. And that one, good stop by the catcher.
We've got black on dark blue.
Yeah.
Luckily, we're young enough that we can somewhat distinguish it.
Well, really, baseball, that's the only sport you can get away with this in. Yeah. I mean, you couldn't do this anywhere else.
But, the yellow accent lines and everything help.
Ball. Ah, 2-1. 2-1.
Yes.
I mean, that one was reason to flinch.
There is a net.
I don't care. Still human instinct.
Oh, man. So the 1-2 coming from Lincoln. And that one up high, 2-2. I like to think of myself somewhat as a Searcy fan by proxy with Coach Heron, the OG Oak Grove basketball coach out at Oak Grove and Maumelle that is now the head coach up at Searcy. That's a good pitch. Strike three called as Lincoln bends that one in over the plate. And so a couple hits, couple walks, and a run for the Wynn Yellow Jackets after a half inning. Wynn leads it 1-0 as Searcy Lions come to bat in the bottom half. Bro, that was almost bad. You about caught me mid-lyric singing that one. I don't know that the folks wanted to hear that.
We don't want to hear you singing anyway, so.
So on the mound for the Wynn Yellow Jackets will be Siler Holbrook. Yeah. Leading things off for the Searcy Lions will be Angel Armin, the shortstop. Armin steps in. Searcy trails this one 1-0. It's Holbrook. He's ready. Look out. Oh, man. That is a tough spot to wear that one. As that ball off the hand and the chest.
And on top of that, it's gotten cold again.
So Armin heads to first, and now the pitcher, Michael Lincoln, will bat. So Lincoln with a chance here, and now we got a timeout called.
We've had two games of warm, and now we're going to have three games of cold.
And swing and a miss by Lincoln. Holbrook ready. He's going to check the runner. Armin back easily. Breaking pitch doesn't break.
The catcher tried framing that.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how.
And the problem for him is he had to move from one box to the other to catch it. So. Okay. I'm going to get away with that frame job. 1-1. Swing and a miss by Lincoln.
A 1-2 count here.
Holbrook is a not a very thickly built young man. And that one outside, 2-2.
Good discipline not to swing at that one because that's one of those very tempting.
Doesn't seem to be a lot of velo off the arm of Holbrook, but he's been effective here against Lincoln and now inside somehow.
Didn't hit him.
I thought for sure that was going to catch Lincoln.
I thought it was going to punk him on the hip.
Lincoln stood in there and was ready for it too. He wasn't going to get out of the way. So now full count. As Armin gets his lead, gets an extra step, he's gone. And a ball lined foul. By the way, if you've not had the honor of heading up to Searcy and checking out that new basketball arena, my goodness gracious, where have you been? Obviously not at the 5A state tournament.
That was obvious.
A beautiful facility. Armin not going this time, and that one behind the head.
I mean, he gets on base either way, but and that's probably the least painful way of getting walked.
Goes behind Lincoln, so now.
Except maybe the escalated heart rate for a few seconds.
Yeah. So hit by a pitch and a walk. First two runners reached. Now batting is Will Bailey.
Bill Bailey.
Will.
No, Bill Bailey.
Will.
You never heard this?
Yes, I have.
Okay.
I was trying to give him the best name in the place there, bud.
I mean, Will is.
Trying to help you out.
I'm not a huge fan.
You're trying to take it away from him.
I'm not a fan of being called Billy.
All right, Billy.
Yeah, boy, I will slap you.
And Holbrook. That one tapped back to him. He'll turn, go to first with it. They'll get the out at first.
They are in second and third now.
That works like a sacrifice bunt. Now the DH, Hunter Figley, will bat. Oh, I tell you, he does not have a lot of velocity, but he's got some stuff now. That pitch fooled the hitter. So Figley awaits the 0-1. That one outside, 1-1. Didn't miss that one by much. Now the 1-1 blows that one by Figley, 1-2.
No guns being used. I'd be interested to see he's probably running like 82, 83.
I would almost honestly be surprised if he's even in the 80s.
This fastball?
Yeah. It's not – it doesn't have a lot of giddy-up on it. Breaking pitch to the third baseman. And now he's got the runner stuck, headed back to third, and he's going to get back safely. So somebody needs to go back and watch The Sandlot on how to run a pickle. As well, Cersei's got the bases loaded with just one out. And now the catcher, Nate Knighton, will step in. There's a strike on the outside corner.
This is not conducive to a quick game.
And, oh, man. So Holbrook fools Knighton on that one. So he pulled the string on that breaking pitch. Now 0-2. The 0-2 on the way. That ball lifted foul out of play. I think we should put a camera on top of the hill next time.
Why?
Why not? Bird's eye view.
Why?
Why not? Bird's eye view.
What did you get the drone for?
Well, where's the drone?
At home.
Well,
or doing something else. Well, I don't know.
0-2 on the way. And good eye. It's a good job by Knighton to lay off of that one.
It would be cool to have the drone up top and then just slowly sink down.
It would have been a lot of fun this year because we could have put like a hit me sign on it for Slade Caldwell and see if he could hit it. Corey may not like that, but man, it'd have been fun. I tell you what, you know, if we do this next year and RJ Hawk gets his way and we got the NIL at the high school level, we can just do an NIL special. Anybody hits the drone gets $500.
Well, okay.
But then we'd have to buy a new drone.
Yeah, and I don't want to do that because that's a lot more than $500. A good drone's about $3,500.
I can promise you we would have some upset coaches because you talk about launch angle. As Knighton swings through that one for strike three. And so two-way now is Dalen Hamilton, the third baseman, will bat.
He looks like he could put some charge into a pitch.
So Holbrook looking to get out of a jam here. Base is loaded. Two outs.
He gets out of this without giving up a run. That's impressive.
And this one tapped and goes foul. This should just be how we decide the game. If Holbrook gets out of this, they win. Ball game. That ball lifted foul, out of play.
He's ahead 0-2 now, real quick.
I'm so cold.
I'm getting there. So 0-2. Base is loaded. Lions, and that ball hit center field. That'll get down. That'll score two. Should score two. And now they'll throw to third as he tries to stretch it.
He's safe.
And he's safe because the third baseman couldn't corral the ball. And so just like that, Cersei wins. Just kidding. That should have been the deal. He got out of it, win one. He didn't? Cersei. First baseman, number one, Chase Taylor. Oh, no. First baseman, Chase Tingler, looks like. And that one cued off the end of the bat. First baseman flips to the pitcher. And that'll do it for our first inning. But Searcy puts two on the board, and they lead this one 2-1 after an inning. Win coming to bat here at the Robinson Invitational on Natural State Sports when we come back. Right, as we are back now for our second inning of work. Same difference. New pitcher into the game for the Lions is Dylan Burns. And first pitch swinging. Oh, gosh, I'm sorry. You're right. We're still Michael Lincoln. We both did that. Sorry about that. It is still Michael Lincoln. Look at the right roster, y'all. Look at the right roster. So now the pitcher, Siler Holbrook. He chased the first one. Evens the count up at 1-1. And ball lifted. Right field. Right field got a beat on it. Makes the play. And it's one away here in the second. Now batting is right fielder Corbin O'Hara for the Yellow Jackets. And Lincoln right down the middle for strike one. Swing and a miss. 0-2. And strike three called on the outside corner. As O'Hara falls victim to the strikeout. And now Lincoln will look to complete a 1-2-3 inning. As Jarrett Henson comes to the plate. First one from Lincoln is up high, 1-0. Again, thanks for joining us on the Natural State Sports Network for the Robinson Invitational. Joined alongside myself, Steve Henson, Will Watkins here as well. And that went inside, buzzed the tower.
It's been a fun couple of days. I hate that we weren't able to do the games yesterday, but out of the precaution of, you know, possible rain for a lot of the day, we decided not to, even though it didn't seem to rain a drop over here. But, you know, we don't have a job where you can be wrong 90% of the time. So. Mm-hmm.
We're not Todd Jacobian.
Got it.
And that ball fouled off our umpire.
Be nice.
And Good job here by our catchers. He'll slowly walk this ball out and have a conversation with the pitcher to give our umpire a chance to shake that one off.
You know, I always tell my kid whenever he falls and trips or something, I tell him, get up and literally shake it off. Just, you know, do a full body shake. And it always distracts him. Maybe we should tell the ump to do the same. Do a full body shake for us. Ah.
Now the 2-1, that's outside for ball three.
It would probably help. It would distract them at least.
Three, one on its way. And this one looped back to Lincoln. Makes the easy catch as Lincoln burns through the wind. Yellow Jacket hitters like a Lincoln log in the top of the second. No score as the Lions lead this one 2-1 as we head to the bottom half of the second inning. All right, we're back as the Wind Yellow Jackets head to the bottom half of the second. Holbrook comes back out for the Yellow Jackets. Will Evans to bat for the Lions, and he cues that one off the end of the bat. Evans back in the box for the 0-1. And that one had everybody buckling.
He lives on the edge on those left-handed hitters.
So 1-1 now the count.
Or right-handed.
I was going to let you have it.
It's on my left.
And that one, dribbler to the third baseman. Scoops, throws, and stayed on the bag to get the out. One away.
Now batting right fielder number 12, Dylan Johnson.
Right fielder Dylan Johnson steps in. Way out in front of that one. Johnson chases that one. She just wants to know. Strike two called on the outside corner.
No, just go
Just go tell me if there's rice. And 1-2. Boy, that was an interesting pitch. And that one had Johnson buckling out of the hand, and he did a good job to recover and just get a piece of that and stay alive. 1-2. 1-2 pitch on the way, and swing and a miss for Dylan Johnson. Two away here in the bottom of the second.
Angel Armin.
We'll go back to the top of the order is the shortstop, Angel Armin. He wore one on the chest. His first at bat. And this time they stay way away from him. All one outside.
There should be two outs in there.
Yeah. Yeah, there's two away.
Okay. Left-handed Mountain Dew.
Oh, man. The delusion has set in.
Excellent.
Sounds like I need to save the half of mine I have left. It's going up in value.
Well, you've already ate out of it, so it has no value.
Hey, somebody's desperate enough. The 1-2 to Armin. Outside, 2-2.
I appreciate it.
2-2 pitch. Went down and got it. And shortstop couldn't make the catch. And that one will fall in for a base hit. Just goes to show sometimes in baseball you just got to be lucky. He didn't hardly get any of that, but just enough of it to get it over the shortstop's glove.
And also, I think the bounciness of the turf probably helps a little too.
And now number 2, the pitcher Michael Lincoln steps in. That one in the carpet, nice stop by the catcher. Now Lincoln looking to help himself out a little bit on the mound here. As he's got a one-run lead. Like to add to it here. 1-0. Misses badly outside and in the carpet. 2-0.
Unless they steal the base here, it's going to be hard for him to help himself out.
Well, I mean, he just hit it out the ballpark. There's that.
Touché.
Winds have pretty well died down. There's still, I think actually the breeze I feel is off that heater. Runner goes.
Well, there you go.
They don't even attempt. I mean, they just.
I guess they're thinking with two outs. Gave it focus to with focus on the guy that played, I guess.
That's a good plan if maybe you had two strikes.
Yeah.
Now it's 3-0. And you're about to bring the three-hole hitter up. You get him out there, at least you start things over. 3-0 pitch. That one's up and in, ball 4. So Lincoln draws the walk. He'll head to first. I got to assume we'll see a courtesy runner come in for him. And
no, because the courtesy runner is out on second.
They will not. So runners at first and second with two away. It's Bailey bats. Will Bailey steps in. First one on the way. Bailey smokes that one right center field. That'll get down. Bobbled by the center fielder. That'll allow one run to score. Throwing it into third, safe. And a double for Will Bailey. Makes it a 3-1 Lion lead.
Now batting for the Lions, number 17, designated hitter Hunter Bigley.
And now the designated hitter Hunter Figley bats. 2 on. That one stays up and in for ball 1. And we got a time out here as a catcher wants to go out and have a conversation with his battery mate.
Perfect time for me to use the hand warmers.
Hey, perfect time for me to finish my story a minute ago.
Oh, yes.
The coach was telling me, I'll zoom out there. Well, I can barely zoom out there because of my monitor, but there's two thin pine trees right behind that fair pole.
Foul pole.
That is where Coach Delaney picked up Slade Caldwell's ball yesterday that he hit out.
So you're probably looking about 380.
380, 400 pretty easily.
I mean, you think it's
– you're talking about
– there's a hill. Too,
that's a
though,
hill so. And another row back. So you got to get all the way back to those two thin pine trees.
Yeah, so you're probably looking 380, 400.
Yeah, easily. He said when it cleared the foul pole and was above the foul pole, almost at the tree line in height, when Caldwell hit that ball. That's a long way. I couldn't hit a ball that hard if I hit it four times.
Every 100 feet, hitting it another 100 feet.
Generous strike call there.
Deuces wild, bottom of the second, two outs, 2-2 count, two on.
A lot of deuces on the board. Oh, got on top of that one. That ball is fair, right down the left field line. One run scores. Two runs will score. And rounding second and stopping there with a double. And the Wynn coach, or the Wynn fans and coaches are not happy. Now we're going to have a conversation here between the Wynn coach and our umpire.
Well, that's a fair ball.
I thought it was fair, too.
Yeah. That's a fair ball. Replay shows it's fair ball, y'all.
I thought it was fair.
Yeah. Well, coach, replay shows it's fair ball.
Hey, they've got it.
It was a fair ball.
I mean, our video shows fair ball. You said know your role.
So Wynn's coach didn't like the explanation he was given, and he'll really not like it when he goes back and watches this game on film and realizes he's wrong.
Now batting catcher number 7, Nate Knighton.
So Nate Knighton will step in. As four runs have now come across for the Lions. And that one called a strike on the outside corner. 0-1. And that one outside, 1-1. One pitch from Holbrook. Swing and a miss. Knighton couldn't catch up to that one.
Some gamesmanship there.
1-2 here from Holbrook. That one up. And count goes to 2-2. It's 2-2, correct?
It's 2-2 now.
A time called here at the plate. We've not corrected the board, but fairly certain it is 2-2. Oh, what a pitch. Strike 3 called, and that is a beauty by Holbrook. So Knighton strikes out looking to end the frame, but Searcy plates 3 runs in the bottom of the second, extends their lead to 5-1. Wynn Yellow Jackets coming to bat in the top half of the third at the Robinson Invitational, Natural State Sports. All right, welcome back. We're set for the top of the third.
Did you enjoy your fried rice?
It's good. I'm almost done with it.
It looks good.
It looks good. That yum-yum sausage, yum-yum.
With the sausage and stuff?
Uh-huh.
I'm going to have to make me some
cauliflower. cauliflower flat rice?
Yeah, cauliflower fried rice with some.
That ball stroked the center field, and that ball off the glove, but controlled by the center fielder.
What am I doing? It's the top of the third. Fix it, will you?
Okay. Get it together!
Yeah, it's the last game of the
I know it.
Night. It's
I mean, let's be honest. Y'all are lucky we're still awake.
Yeah, pretty much. We're just going to roll all this stuff up and throw it in your vehicle, and I'm going home.
Boy, I got to unload it and go do more work.
Oh, tonight?
Mm-hmm. Jeez. Cat Williams is here. And the runner goes, and he is safe by a mile. Good jump there.
Half a mile, not a mile. like 2,500 feet, not 5,000, whatever.
All right, let's just split hairs over here.
I'm splitting something.
That one low and outside. 1-1 the count. That went in the dirt, the carpet, burning rubber.
Yeah. There's one person sitting out in the outfield. They've been there for a while.
They like that spot.
They like being secluded.
That went up and out of the zone, 3-1.
I mean, I bet it's a pretty good place to watch a game. But with the wind and stuff that happened today, I wouldn't even come close to sitting out there.
Yeah, it was cold out there putting that camera up.
Does any of our other places have outfield seats?
No. And that one high as Kendall Reed draws the walk. And that one nobody out. Win. A little something cooking here with runners at first and second. We're going to get a timeout. Let's see if Cersei will stick with Michael Lincoln or make a change here.
Change I want is to hit home.
I know it. Come on, coach. Don't wait till the umpire comes out there and tells you to shut it down.
Please.
Don't make a change. Make a change.
Here it comes. Slowly but surely.
They will not make the change. We're going to stick with Lincoln.
Is his name Abe?
No.
Okay.
It's Mike.
Mike Lincoln. Eh, I like Abe.
Honestly, though, so Robertson steps in. That one up and in.
Hard time finding the zone right now.
Seemed to be the story of our last two games. And, again, to be honest, not completely unexpected as you get to day three here. The runners go. Throw down to third is high. And good play by the third baseman to get up and get that. A terrible job by our producer switching to the third base cam.
The third base camera wasn't even there to get the action.
It's on third that all times, sir.
I was thinking of your camera.
There's a reason we're using four cameras. And that one right at the second baseman goes down and gets it, and they got the double play. Great job there by the Lions to turn the double play. And just like that, there are two away now here in the third. Win. Runner on third now. And now the Red Planet comes to the plate.
Who?
The Red Planet.
What are you talking about?
His name is Cy Mars.
Oh. What have we talked about giving people nicknames?
Dude, it would be just the most beautiful thing ever if he was wearing my space socks right now. That ball dribbled down the third base side, and good job by the third baseman to play that foul. What are we?
Wind fans are giving him heck now. He's laughing. I love it.
You got to have a sense of humor. You do.
Oh, great.
I mean, that's a great job by our umpire. I love it. I mean, and there's a strike. Strike two called. I think our catcher thought that was strike three.
He popped up ready to go to the dugout.
He did. He was flexing. He was ready to go.
A 2-2
count. As funny as that was, I don't think the Wind fans are going to think it's too funny when they go back and see that was a fair ball. And that went outside a little too much.
No, that last one was 3-2. Definitely a foul ball.
So full count. Right?
Yep.
Okay.
3-2.
Again, I don't trust that board. Now it's fixed. Again.
You're just impatient.
Well, that one took a while. That ball popped up. Catcher, third base, give chase. Third baseman couldn't make the catch. That ball tailed on him at the very last minute.
Was that a foul ball?
Yes. I'm pretty sure it was. I don't know. Yeah. Maybe not.
That was a joke.
I know. Okay. I know. Was that fair or foul?
Dang, it was fair.
So we'll do the 3-2 all over again. It's Lincoln trying to get out of this one. 3-2 pitch on its way, outside, ball four. So Mars walks. He'll head down to first. Now it'll be runners at the corners with two outs. As Cooper Thompson, the designated hitter, steps to the plate. All right, my hands are getting cold now. That ball hit deep. Not too deep. Actually, got to come in for it. That ball was just kind of looped out there. So, and safe. Didn't get the tag in time. But that'll score a second run for the Yellow Jackets. I will say that once we finally get to call a game over in the new Maumelle Hornet baseball field, I do like the fact that our broadcast spot will be elevated over there.
Yeah. That's nice. It's the same thing over at Sylvan Hills Baseball. It's up in the press box they've got. It's nice.
Yeah, ours isn't covered yet, but that's the plan for next year is to build it, is to close it in on the top.
Oh, nice. Okay.
So hopefully that happens. That one well outside, 1-1.
They're making the investment to make you comfortable. I don't like that.
You know, I got to sit in that awful press box every Friday. You know, it's tough.
I know. You're living the rough life.
It's terrible over there, I tell you. That ball hit to the shortstop. Scooped up, goes to second, and that ball gets by. That's going to let one run score. That'll go to third, safe. That one gets by. That'll allow the runner to get to second.
We wild now.
As we we're doing our best Bad News Bears impressions out here. On a couple of those plays.
What?
And so now Siler Holbrook, the pitcher, will bat. He's got a chance to
tie the game.
Tie this game right back up.
I want some wheat thins. There's some whipped cream.
That one up and in. And now time called.
I just wore the up, just yelled foul.
That would have been even better. That would have been awesome. This place would have come unglued.
That is great.
Long drive for these Wind Yellow Jacket fans. Got a few of them that have made the trip.
Is it really? An hour and a half?
More than that, dude. It's all the way on the east side of the state. Way out there. Ooh. Wow. He got Holbrook to chase there. He'll fall behind one and two.
An hour and 47 minutes.
Okay. Shorter than I thought. Oh, it's way over there, though. That one, nice stop by the catcher. That's a great play.
In reality, you could probably get there an hour and a half if you're going fast enough.
Hey, but continued prayers out to the Wind community. I know it's been right almost a year since those tornadoes came through here in Wind. That's a good pitch, 2-2.
Yeah, they're rebuilding. I've kept up with it on Facebook because they do it. The district, I know, does a good job of putting out update videos and stuff. And community came together to get that cleaned up and working on rebuilding.
2-2 pitch, Lincoln. It's high, 3-2. The 3-2 pitch from Lincoln. That one's down on the carpet. And that'll load the bases up now with two outs. And we'll see how much longer the Lions are going to stick with Lincoln. Lincoln had a very efficient second inning. Set the Yellow Jackets down in order. And was cruising really here through the third. And now has found himself scuffling a little bit here with two outs. We'll get the courtesy runner. Number 10, Evan McConnell. And now we got a time being called, and now they're ready.
Coach is arguing fair or foul. I just don't know what on.
Is that number 6? I think this is a pinch hitter, Luke Hess. And strike 1 called right down the middle. And it is Luke Hess is the Yellow Jacket hitter. Now the 0-1 pitch from Lincoln. That one low, ball 1.
Right at an hour into this game.
And we're not even through 2.5.
Oh. Almost.
We've been almost through 2.5 for a while now. Now we're through 2.5. Oh, wait, that's strike 2. Just kidding. I'm ahead of myself. See how much, that's how fast I want to be done.
See, let's have you argue fair and foul.
We'll be here all night. Actually, no, we wouldn't, because I'd be irate enough. He'd just throw me out and say, let's move on, y'all.
Yeah, you.
There's strike 3 called. As Lincoln battles back, he'll sit down Hess and win. Scores 2 in the top half of the third, but that's going to do it for them. And we'll head to the bottom half of the third as the Lions come to bat leading 5-3. You almost got it.
I quit singing.
We're taking our time. We want to be here till 10.
No, we don't. I don't know who you are, but I don't. I want to be out of here by 8.
Wouldn't be great. That ain't happening. So Holbrook.
I mean, they could escalate quick enough.
Out for the bottom half of the third. Hamilton to bat for the Lions. Hamilton sits back on that one. Third baseman makes the play across to first. And one away. One down. Batter will be Chase Tingler to bat. I was pretty sure that was the name, but they scratched one out, wrote a new one in, and it's a little hard to read.
Nobody's corrected us yet.
Holbrook. That one coming right at now. No flinch. No flinch.
I don't know why I'm taunting because I'm still losing. This is like golf. Lower score wins.
Oh.
I need to go bowling again. Candace and I went a couple for last weekend. I enjoyed it.
Holbrook threw the signs again. Now he's ready. Pitch on the way. That one down in the carpet.
We should all go bowling some night.
I want to do bowling, and I want us all to go to the go-kart track. No.
Bologna.
A go-kart track in Bologna. And there's a strike from Holbrook.
I've never swung a golf club like at a real golf course
in my
life.
I have no urge to go to Top Golf. It's way too expensive just to
swing a
hit a few balls around. That went outside.
No flinch.
I would hope not. You flinch on that one, I'm done with you.
Well, now, if I was falling asleep or something and they come, I could see it, but like.
Oh.
What's what? That's a tent, like a.
Oh, yeah, those, yeah.
You can get a chair that has enclosure thing on it.
Yeah, it's that enclosed thing, so you can sit inside of it if it's raining or cold. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I don't know that it would be very helpful.
If it's raining, sure, but.
Yeah, cold. I mean, unless you have a heater in there.
3-2. Pitch is strike three called as Holbrook bent that one over, buckled the knees of Tingler.
What's his name?
I'll be out number two. His name is Chase Tingler. Will Evans to bat with two away here in the Lion half of the third. Oh, man.
He's got his breaking ball working.
It is a slow floating breaking ball, but it definitely breaks off really hard at the end. It makes it a little harder to get a hold of. Especially if he can spot it right where he just did. Now, that one.
Oh, that's nice.
It's a nice pitch, but I got to tell you, if I'm Cersei, that's his best pitch.
Yeah.
I'm sitting back, and if that ball starts at my hip, I'm going to lay back on my back foot, and I'm putting that ball somewhere on the softball field over there. I mean, of course, if I was talented enough to do that.
I was going to say, no, you'd probably swing and miss.
0-2. Oof. Wow. Chasing that one is Will Evans for strike three. So Holbrook sits him down here in the bottom of the third. We'll head to the fourth. Cersei leading at 5-3 here on the Natural State Sports Network and the Robinson Invitational. are now set and ready. Top half of the fourth. The Yellow Jackets come to bat. Lincoln still on the mound for the Lions. First pitch swinging. And that one will go out of be a foul ball.
Fair ball. When fans are not very amused by it.
No, they're probably sick of us.
We ain't doing anything wrong.
That's my story, and I'm sticking to it.
Well, you're always doing stuff wrong, so.
Lincoln, strike two called. All right, we need to play these last couple innings in 19 minutes, fellas. Let's get her done. 0-2 on the way. That ball bouncing. A tough play. Third baseman cuts it off, comes across, throws across to first, and safe. Over at first base. So a base runner here is go back to the top of the order. Number seven, shortstop, Gray Westbrook.
And I like these rocking chairs, but it's apparently very common for them to be squeaky. I'm hearing them all over the place.
Yep. That breaking ball didn't break. Oh, my Lord. It is getting cold.
Yeah.
Oh, my. And now the 1-0. That one hit. Shortstop. Backhands it. Goes to second for one. That's all they'll get. Now the center fielder, Kendall Reed, steps to the plate. One away. Here in the fourth, runner on first. That's Lincoln. First one up. 1-0 the count. And, whoa, they had him leaning. Oh, and the ball gets past the first baseman all the way down into the right field corner. And the runner will hold at second.
He probably could have made it to third.
Yeah. Little surprised they weren't a bit more aggressive there. Oh, my God. Runner goes. They'll try to get him at third. And no throw.
For whatever reason, they had no interest in trying to get him at third.
I'm not sure the third baseman got over there. So now 1-1 count. That's a good pitch. 1-2. I think Lincoln missed his spot, but got away with it there. So now 1-2, one away, runner at third. In a 5-3 ball game, Lions lead it. Lincoln, that one got away from him. Stays up and in, 2-2. Again, good job by the catcher. Set up down and away and had to dive up and in to get that one. Lincoln trying to get the second out here in the fourth. Oof. That one seemingly has been a strike most of the game. So now a full count. And that one inside, Lincoln loses him. So Reed walks. Now We got runners at the corners with just one away here in the fourth. Will, every time it feels like we're going to start cruising through an inning,
things happen.
Things slow down.
Yeah, that's baseball.
Mm-hmm.
So famous last words of the Arkansas fan base. That's baseball.
Reed over at first. That one's up.
Just a little bit, not too far, not too much from the zone.
There's David Robertson.
Really need this game to speed up. It is way too cold.
Yeah.
And we don't have a crew of people to help us tear down.
The good thing is the tear down won't be out. Runner goes. And catcher dropped it on the transition. Now we're going to get him anyway.
But they call a strike.
Yeah, strike called.
So one hit here can tie the game.
One and one count with one away. Lincoln trying to fight through this one. That one fouled off on the net.
No flinch.
One and two.
Hey, she's got an advantage. She's been. This is her third day.
Mm-hmm.
She's more used to the.
And that's a good pitch. Robertson hung around there. Count stays one and two.
He gonna strike him out here, probably.
I sure hope so.
That bender.
Right, I'm not rooting for anybody. I'm just rooting for the game to get over. And that one in the carpet, two and two.
And this would be good where you can have rotational commentary and production and stuff. That way we're not sitting here in game five of the night saying, let's get this over with.
Well,
this is their only game of the day, and we're like, oh, let's.
Ooh, swing and a miss. As Robertson couldn't catch up to that one. Two-way. Well, and again, this was a this was an event that we kind of, well, I kind of decided last minute to come and do. And we're going to get a, I think we're going to get a pitching change here as Mars comes to bat.
If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands.
They hurt too bad.
Okay. Well, you're not happy either. You're grouchy.
Well, I'm happy. I'm tired, but I'm happy. I'm just cold.
If you're grouchy and your name is Steve, clap your hands.
Oh, my hands hurt too bad. So they'll stick with Lincoln. Two outs here in the fourth. As Mars steps to the plate.
The yawning is in full effect now.
Now Lincoln set. And that one a little off the plate.
Foul ball.
1-0. Oh, jeez.
I'm delusional at this point.
Mm-hmm.
I can smell the finish line.
How's it smell?
Glorious.
Ball punched into right field. That's a base hit. One run will score. They'll hold the runner at third. A single for Mars makes it a 5-4 ball game.
I will ask, though, how many outside of minor league, college, major league, and then your state championship games. How often do you see these multi-camera high school broadcasts?
Not many. I mean, not even really at the.
At the minor leagues is very, it's rare.
It's rare. Yeah, I mean, it's rare at the college level. Like, I caught myself flipping through on YouTube and was watching the, what was that, SAU and SNU.
Oh, yeah.
And it was just a home plate cam.
Yeah.
They just had one camera back at above home plate.
I mean, that's how I'm going to run my Slippin' Hills games. But,
yeah.
It's, you know, elevated and everything, so you get a good view. But, yeah.
2-0 pitch. Golf swing. Couldn't catch up to it. It was Thompson.
We ain't at Top Golf, are we? Think it's his dad over here.
There is a net. Don't fall into it.
I was going to say, I'm not going to fall into it. Like that lady did at Top Golf.
Thompson swinging a miss on the 2-1 as he was fooled badly on that pitch.
Apparently that ain't him.
Who is it then? That's weird.
I know. Let's talk about confusing. Deuces wild. 2-2 count. Two out. Two on.
And 3-2. Ball three.
We know that it's not a strike because this ump's pretty demonstrative with his third strike calls. I like it.
I do too.
Shortstop sunglasses look like cops.
Center field's the same.
Yeah. Thursday night, I thought they had a little like flashing LEDs on them.
And the runner goes. And that one spoiled.
Into the net.
It's fouled back.
Got chills.
Mm-hmm.
I need a real meal.
Mm-hmm. 3-2. Runner first will be off with the pitch. Mars goes, and it's ball four. So Thompson walks. Now Noah Stewart will come to the plate with two away, and the base is loaded. 23, second baseman, Noah Stewart. Here's a good pitch. Lincoln pumps that one in for a strike.
You were saying it was going to be like a 12-9 game?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's kind of looking like it.
I don't know how much pitching Cersei has left. It obviously looks like they're going to ride Lincoln until the wheels fall off.
The pun, because he's a Lincoln Navigator.
I mean, it's just a Ford. We get it. It'll fall apart. That went up and away. 1-2.
Bro, you drive a Nissan with a CVT, don't you?
No.
Yours doesn't have a CVT
mm-mm.
in it?
Mm-mm.
I was going to say, you have no room to talk about breaking down.
They got rid of those.
I don't know. Nissan Altimas still have CVTs.
That's
and
an
the Rogues do too.
So the 1-2.
Oh.
Oh, my goodness.
That's one way to tie the game.
That one plunks him. And so Stewart goes to first, and that's going to do it for Lincoln. That'll be the end of the rope. The wheels have officially fallen off the Navy.
Oh, were they the spinners?
Cersei will make a pitching change here.
22-inch spinners on the shot collar.
And they're all flat.
I think he's going to play in the field now. Yep. Shortstop, maybe?
Lincoln.
Or is he headed out to the outfield?
It looks like he's going to the outfield. So coming into the game will be number 17 for the Lions. That is Hunter Figley.
Yeah, who's he replacing?
Well, he was the DH. So
he sent the left fielder, I think.
Who was that?
Never saw his number.
Oh, so he'll replace Marshall McNeese, who was playing in the field but not hitting.
What?
That's the DH.
Oh, okay. I don't know if I've ever noticed someone playing in the field but not hitting.
Mm-hmm.
That's different.
So Figley will try to wiggle out of a jam here.
Head up, young man. He's out there kind of squatted there at center field. Keep your head up. Still tied game, so. A long way to go, apparently.
Yeah. And the bases are still loaded.
Yeah.
All those runners are the responsibility of Lincoln. It's Figley.
But really, all Figley needs is one pitch, and they can get out of it. So.
All we need is a pitcher on both sides that can fill up the zone is what we need.
Yeah.
Let them hit it.
No, don't let him hit it. We need strikeouts. We need ground outs.
It'll go a lot quicker if they hit the first pitch in the ground ball and then get them out. Let them hit it. Let your defense work. Figley, though, at least warming up right now. Looks like he's all in the zone. He's not been wide of anything yet.
Watch, he's going to throw a wild one here.
Figley says, break it up, fellas. I'm ready to pitch.
Well, I think the ump told him how many pitches he had left a couple of pitches ago. Because he put his finger up to the catcher.
Your attention, now pitching for the Searcy Lions, number 17, Hunter Figley.
Siler Holbrook will step in.
Left fielder wants to get out there.
First one on the way from Figley is a strike. Now the 0-1. That one outside. I really had high hopes that we would not still be here and able to see the lights of the towers on Chenal Mountain.
I mean, the last game was scheduled for 6:15 or 6 o'clock, so, I mean, not really that surprising.
Could have been out of here.
Not really. You were just...
No, but seriously, this has been just an absolutely fantastic event. We've had a great time.
Even as cold as it's been.
These last two games have drug on. This one lifted right side. First baseman coming over, and he'll make the catch in foul territory to retire the side. But win. It's two runs in the top half of the fourth to tie this one up at 5 with the Searcy Lions coming to bat in the bottom half of the inning. All right, so as we head to the bottom of the fourth, in a tie ball game, 5-5. Holbrook continues out on the mound for the Yellow Jackets.
I need to fix your camera between innings.
Swinging away. Miss at the first one. Now batting is number 12, Dylan Johnson. How's it 1-0? It's 0-1, is it not? He yeah, swung it. There. Oh, and that, well, don't matter now because that one plunked him dead center of the back. And so Johnson will go down to first.
Is that a foul ball?
How about next hitter that takes one in the back, that team wins. So we have had quite a few hit by pitches over the last two games as well. Now time called at the plate. And batters, we go back to the top of the order, the shortstop Angel Armin. That went outside, ball one. And now the 1-0. Runner goes. Throw down to second, not in time. So Johnson steals second. Gets himself into scoring position here. And 2-0 pitch. Outside, ball three. Armin working the count here. And that's ball four outside. So Armin goes down to first.
Now their pitcher is struggling to find the zone.
Holbrook has struggled off and on throughout.
Shortstop's going to come in and talk as well. Here comes first baseman. We're
going to have a whole meeting of the minds on the mound.
As long as they can get the strike zone.
And so.
Pops is coming out to tell him to speed it up. And they said, okay, we'll get out.
So our umpire breaks that up.
He didn't even have to. They saw him coming.
And so Lincoln steps in. You got to believe Lincoln wants to get a few of those runs back here. And that one in the carpet.
What are they yelling over there?
1-0. No telling. Baseball players, they yell all kinds of fun stuff. Most of it don't make a dang bit of sense. Now the 1-0 from Holbrook. That one, strike called.
A high strike there.
Wide strike.
Oh, yeah, but
that ball was in the other batter's box. But I'm not going to argue because
get this home pass.
Keep on moving. Oh, this is a good game. 5-5. Second baseman sneaks in. Made it close. Johnson gets back. And so we're still runners at first and second. Nobody out here in the bottom of the fourth. Holbrook set. And a ball.
Ooh, how did that not hit him?
Did not break. And so Lincoln ahead 2-1. Oh, Lincoln chased ball three. Hard to lay off them high fastballs. They look so good in your eyes.
Here comes that bender.
I'll count even at 2-2. Two and two on its way. And again, somehow doesn't hit Lincoln. It's 3-2. We've officially been at the ballpark for 12 hours, Will.
Mm-hmm. Yep. 11 hours of broadcasting, and that hour is set up, and we'll have about 40 minutes of tear down. It's a lot easier to tear down than it is set up.
And set up really wasn't bad with all the wiring already run. So now the 3-2 pitch coming from Holbrook, and he'll step off. Two pitch on the way, and that's outside ball four. So Lincoln draws the walk. That'll be bases loaded, and I think we're going to get a pitching change here for the Yellow Jackets. And they will make a change, as it looks like. No, he's making a change. He pointed at somebody. So, new pitcher actually coming, 10. New pitcher coming out of the dugout is number 10, Evan McConnell. So, McConnell will come out and get some warm-up pitches, and we'll be back here in just about 2 minutes. Man, I ran all the way over here just for them to have another discussion. Yeah. And get their signs correct. With a runner at second, I would assume that's what that conversation is.
Don't assume, Steve.
Well, this is not an assumption, but if I have to use the restroom again, I'm going in the woods because the porta-potties have about worn out their use.
There are a couple of them that still aren't full.
Pretty rough. And McConnell missed on that one.
I didn't flinch. I just looked up. I just flinched. I did not flinch.
I don't think he flinched on that one. I'm going to give him credit.
I just looked up.
I don't think he flinched.
Of course, I'm also eating a protein bar, so maybe why.
So that'll score a run. And now Searcy takes a 6-5 lead. Everybody moves up a base. McConnell's... Oh. Yeah, 2-1 on the flinch count. 1-1 on the scoreboard count. And that one high, 2-1. I'm just glad we're not the only one getting tired.
Yeah.
The truth of the matter is that one bounces right back at us.
That one,
no,
could have
all right.
The camera. She flinched.
No, I wasn't. I didn't see her, but I'm gonna trust her.
Don't listen to him.
Down one.
And so, don't listen to him. He's mad I didn't play his walk-up song.
So the count is 3-1 as two runs have scored, 7-5. And a very generous strike two call on the inside corner. And so the count goes full at 3-2. And ball four.
Still nobody out.
So Bailey walks. Now Hunter Figley will bat. Nobody out. 7-5. Runners at the corners. Strike called on the outside corner. Who's climbing fences? Oh, they're banging on that fence over there. It's like, what is happening? 0-1. That one bending in. And second baseman going back, makes the catch, and immediately gets it back into the catcher. The runner does not try to tag. And so one away. Good play out there by the second baseman. Now coming to the plate is number 7, the catcher, Nate Knighton. That went off a fist and foul. Runners get their leads. Yeah, that's a good pitch. McConnell drops that breaking pitch in. Count 0-2 with one away. Two runs in here in the fourth. Runner goes. That one in the carpet. Good stop by the catcher. So give second to the runner. And so Knighton steps back in there. 1-2. That one.
Oh.
Outside, 2-2.
Just a little outside.
A 2-2 pitch. And that one poked foul.
Fair. That's fair ball. Wind fan didn't look very amused when he looked over right here. I'm out. Someone. Runner out of seconds. You know, clapping his hands. Apparently, he's happy.
And now the 2-2. Outside, ball three.
My hands are cold up. I don't want to take it out of the hoodie.
Seriously, if they hit the ball, I'm not sure I'm going to get to that camera to move it.
Get you some hand warmers or toe warmers.
Do no good.
Yeah, they do. Well, okay.
Ah, there it is. Flinched. He flinched. 3-1.
That one came right at me. Y'all are some mean people.
Uh-huh. You're falling behind in a hurry, Will.
I don't care. I'm tired. I'm ready to go.
It's a full count.
That thing was coming right at me.
And swinging a miss. As McConnell blows that one by Knighton. And two away here in the fourth inning. Third baseman Dalen Hamilton steps to the plate.
McConnell. Okay, two outs.
Swing and a miss.
Jeez, Cole.
My sun went down. It dropped 15 degrees, it feels like. That went outside. 1-1.
I'd say it's
52.
Probably.
That's what my watch says. I may be chubby, but I ain't built for this.
52 feels like 49.
And that one outside. 2-1.
What are you talking about? I'm fat and I'm not built for this. Albeit, you know, I'm having the weight loss, so I do get cold quicker.
I bet.
Now, a lot quicker.
Mm-hmm. That ball lifted right side. Long run to the fence.
And our camera just went out.
Did it hit the camera?
No, I'm just kidding.
I was about to say, it's in that area.
I know. That's why I said it.
Well, yay. Yay! Here went 2 grand. So now 2-2, two outs. Deuces on the board. That ball rope, right field, right at the right fielder. Can he get there? It clears his head. That's going to score 2. And a double for Dalen Hamilton. That'll make it 9-5 here in the fourth.
Hey.
They're only doing that to stay warm. You can't convince me otherwise.
Yeah.
Now, first baseman, Chase Tingler, which is about what my toes are doing at this point, tingling.
Well, get some toe warmers and put it in your shoes.
I don't want to because then my feet would be cold when I take my shoes off.
Oh, my God.
Look, man, I am trying to just tough it out.
Hey, these feel pretty good on my hands.
Oof. Ball up, 1-0.
How is that not a strike in, in anyone's world except mine? In all confession, I just want to go home.
That one fouled away.
I didn't flinch. Up, back.
Oh.
But I do see white dots in my eyes now. I look right up there at those LED lights.
Yeah, I don't even look up anymore. I mean, if I get hit in the head, I get to go home.
You're not getting hit in the head unless I do it.
Pat, I'll run out there in the street on the next one. That one out of... off the plate, 2-0.
I think that's 3-0.
Probably.
No, 2-1, because then he just fouled a ball.
He did just foul one off, 2-1. I got to stop trusting the scoreboard operator, because I'm fairly certain that her fingers are frozen as she tries to write in the book over there.
Yeah.
And then she can't push the buttons on the controller.
Now it's 3-1.
I really do feel for our scoreboard operator right now, because she is struggling. I will give our scoreboard operators a hard time in basketball because they're inside a gym. But tonight, she deserves all the credit in the world as Tingler walks. And the fourth inning continues as coming to bat is number 13, Will Evans.
Number 13, Will Evans.
So Evans will step in with them striped socks. And strike one called on the outside corner. Now the 0-1. That one hit to the third baseman. Comes up, makes the play across to first. And that'll do it. But Searcy answers. Wins two runs in the top half with four of their own in the bottom half. And Searcy leads this one 9-5 as we head to the top of the fifth here on Natural State Sports Network. Leading things off will be Elijah Havner for the Yellow Jackets. First pitch on its way. Strike one. Oh. He swings right through that one.
It would have helped if I moved to a camera that shows the action.
Probably.
It's that kind of night.
Mm-hmm.
Cold and my mind is slow.
That one low, 1-1.
Oh, man, I just put my hand back in my pocket.
So Figley, yeah, Figley back out on the mound. For Searcy, that one low, 2-1. Yeah, what do we got?
Uh-oh, he's coming to get me.
What's happening?
Trouble.
He's thirsty. What's that?
They've got their headlights
on bright. Oh. All right. Hey, they have any barbecue? Can you ask him for me?
No, I'm good. I've had enough. Thank you. Now the 2-1 on its way, and that one, how did that not hit him?
We've asked that about 100 times tonight.
No idea. That ball did not hit him. Again, we're shielded where we are, but I'm not sure that ball hit him. Now 3-1. Swing and a miss. It's Havner. Couldn't lay off the high inside cheese. And count goes full. And a 3-2. Strike three called as Havner gets caught looking. Fastball on the outside corner. And that'll be out number one here in the fifth. I say, I bet you can take that down at this point.
Yeah, probably.
Now McConnell will bat. And this one fouled out of play.
Watch out. Oh, thank you.
I put it back in front of the heater, warm it back up. See, I can have a little bit of carbs, so I'll eat that sandwich with one piece of the bread.
That one fouled away. That one's going for the bright light car. Okay, let's go.
There we go.
Teach you to turn your bright lights on out there. So 0-2. That one just a little low. 1-2. Now Figley trying to retire his battery mate. And strike three. Catcher picks it up, tags him out. That's out number two. Like, I really want to drink water, but I really don't want to take my hands out of my pockets. I wish I could figure out a way to make that water jump up here. Who's messaging me?
They're talking about baseball movies back there.
Oh, gosh. I got a bot who appreciates my profile on Facebook.
Yeah.
And they're a Chinese living in Los Angeles, and their name is Sarah Beth. They would like to make some friends for better traveling in the future. Love it.
Why are you getting notifications from Jay Davis? Are you?
I have no idea. Let's see what account that's on. It's on the Maumel Sports Network. I have no idea.
Bad algorithm there.
I get some weird ones on a few of those, like some weird political ones. I'm like, I don't even look at politics on there. This ball lifted out of play. What's the count? 2-1? Is that for real?
Yeah, okay.
2-1. 2-1 count. Two away. It's Figley looking to get out of this inning. Oh.
Good discipline to not.
I say he didn't go.
Yeah, he wasn't close.
That one up and in, ball four.
Okay, walks are not conducive to pass games.
So apparently Eric Musselman will be returning to the University of Arkansas.
That's just
if you believe that.
I don't believe anything.
Oh, gosh. Apparently my wife messaged me and I missed it like an hour ago.
Oh, well.
That one so inside, and the runner goes.
You probably through. Have one at home waiting.
I doubt it.
You doubt it?
I highly doubt that.
I don't usually answer. Candace will give me something.
No. She should know that. Well, I guess she hadn't been here enough to know how much food we've been
provided.
Thrown at us. I do appreciate the folks here and the hospitality. That rice was good. The burgers were good. Oh. Look out. Did they not hit him?
No, apparently not.
Mercy.
How? I don't know.
No idea.
But it's 2-0 count on him. Two outs, and runner is now up to third base.
It's like we just cannot get that third out of every inning.
Any inning.
So Reed, ahead in the count, 2-0, is now we've run it all the way around to third. A 2-0 pitch. Swing and a miss as Reed was trying to put that one on the softball field.
I need to find a McDonald's for some decaf coffee.
Because there's not one if I go Highway 10 to Highway 9, that's for sure.
There's not one that way either.
There's not one on Kentrell?
That ball lifted right side. First baseman camped out underneath it. He'll make the catch, and that'll end the inning. So a little noise by the Yellow Jackets, but they can't scratch a run across. And after four and a half, Searcy leads this one 9-5 as they come to bat in the bottom of the fifth. Dylan Johnson will lead things off for the Lions here in the bottom of the fifth. Is it too much to ask for six runs here? What? I'm just saying.
You want a drink? I'm up.
Make it three.
Pulled pork sandwich pretty good.
Yeah, it was. I had one Thursday. Look out! Another one under the fists of the hitter as McConnell misses badly with that one. 3-0 the count. And ball four. So Johnson walks. Move back to the top of the order, and Angel Armin for the Lions. Going low. 1-0. That ball hit hard right field. That's trouble as it finds the gap. Right fielder gets it, brings it in. He missed his cutoff. And we'll roll all the way to third. And so that'll allow Armin to go into second with a double. And now with nobody out, Searcy's got runners at second and third. With Michael Lincoln coming to the plate. Again, we appreciate everybody joining us. We've got a few folks in the comments. Is that one low strike called? This has been a fantastic Robinson Invitational. We've had a blast bringing it to you. Hope you guys have enjoyed it. That one in the carpet got away, but won't allow the runners to advance. Now the 1-1 pitch. That ball hit hard left field, going back at the wall and off the wall. That'll score two runs as that ball traveled about 359 feet.
How about, yeah, from a 360-foot spot at the wall.
He couldn't have hit it. If he'd have hit it just a little to the right, I think that ball's out.
Yeah, he hit it right there as it went up.
And so that scores two runs on the Lincoln double.
Now, that netting over there, that's a softball field, right? That's not.
Yeah, okay. That's softball field.
I was going to say, that's not on the
baseball field. Well, no, that is. That's behind the base, the fence to keep, because there's stands right there.
Okay.
Yeah, that is right behind the baseball field.
So, foul balls from softball can get in the baseball field?
There's a net on that end, too, for softball, too. That is to keep any ball hit out from hitting fans behind them.
I know that, but I guess I don't know how close the field is.
It's right across. I mean, there's a big walkway there. Like, there's large area like this between that fence and the field. But that net is basically just protection for the fans that would be at a softball game if somebody hit one out over there. And so new pitcher now into the game is number 28. That is Cy Mars. Comes in to pitch. So nobody out.
It's a 6-run game here. Get 4 runs.
It's over.
Yep.
Why do you think I said what I said?
I know what you said. I just didn't acknowledge it.
Again, we're not rooting against anybody. I'm just rooting for warmth.
That's what I'm rooting for, is the warmth. Hey, it's cold.
Man, and there's Coke and Texarkana. Coca-Cola. I can't say the other word. It's a high school broadcast. I'm not Justin Akery.
Okay.
Whoa.
Oh, what a bender.
All right. I like it.
I did not think that was coming.
I didn't think it was going to get to the plate, to be honest.
That was a 50-mile-an-hour curveball that just whoop right in.
That one hits Bailey.
Bill Bailey goes Bonneville.
Bailey heads first. The runner's at first and second.
And nobody out. Is it? So I've got to ask you, because for basketball season, you do like 30-minute post-game shows. Is it weird cutting broadcasts so quickly after baseball games?
That ball hung up there, but caught by the third baseman. And Lincoln got back before being doubled off. You know, I mean, in a setup like this, no, because, I mean, we know we've got to just roll from game to game to game. Now, potentially in the future, I would love to have an opportunity to where we could interview after these games, and that one gets by the catcher. So runners will move up. Second and third now as – Nate Knighton bats, but I think once we get into a groove of doing baseball, just regular baseball nights, sure. Now, in this next year, I'd love to have more of an interview setup that we could do. Maybe somebody else do the interviews that's not on play-by-play between games.
Yeah,
I think that'd be kind of cool to do, but. No, and again, in a situation like this where we're just trying to get through game after game. Mars. It's that one past Knighton. Count goes to 1-2. One away. Runners second and third.
Base hit. Scores two.
That's a fair ball.
Knighton fists that one off. It was not a fair ball.
But it's fun to say.
I know it. But we don't have a camera on it, so you're confusing the people.
Yeah.
Because I didn't feel like moving. Because I knew it was foul. Another 1-2. And Mars reaches back and blows that one by Knighton. And now there's two away. And now Dalen Hamilton will bat. So Hamilton steps in. And that one down on the carpet.
Best baseball movie out there is Angels in the Outfield.
That went up. 2-0.
I know that's random, but that's what they're talking about.
I hear them. I hear them. That is a good game. It is a good movie. Now the 2-0 from Mars. That literally just.
Whoa.
Huh?
What? What happened? Did he swing?
No, maybe with his head.
No, that's a strike.
I know he called it a strike.
No, watch. Like, it's in
the
zone.
The ball bend over into the zone? How about that? Zone.
Holy cow.
And that one's outside. I thought it hit his helmet.
We got to watch this. This is crazy. Yeah, I mean.
It is right down the middle, actually.
He just. Wow.
All right. So 3-1. That ball.
I didn't flinch. I was watching the ball from the bat to the fence. Thank you. Y'all are rude.
You done lost anyway. You're down 3-1.
No, I'm up 3-1.
No.
Yeah. She gets a weighted number because she's been here for 3 days.
Okay.
I've been here for a day
off.
And a half.
Look out.
That one didn't break.
That would
zone.
Not. That one definitely. Did not break as the run scores. Lincoln comes across to score. Now we got time. We're picking the best baseball.
Oh, okay. Well, the way he has that breaker or that breaking ball, he needs to make sure the grooves are nice and fat.
So now stepping in is number one, Chase Tingler. And Tingler's got a chance to walk it off here. Two outs, runners at the corners. 12-5 ball game.
Yeah, he's going to have to hit a home run to do that, though.
Left that one high, 1-0.
I'd be okay with that, though, because I got to go. Home.
I'm going with Tingler. That's right back up the middle. That's a base hit. That'll score the 13th run. And now they're going to play with our emotions, Will.
Yes, they are. Yes, they are.
And now Will Evans.
Let's go, teams. Hey. It's cold.
I think we've officially reached the temperature that it's not allowed to play at anymore.
I think we've officially reached the temperature of senile people.
Mars.
Look at that bender.
Goodness gracious. That ball just
the fact that it
floats
bends like that.
In there.
Float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. That's what it does.
Somebody should paint a butterfly on that ball. Another good one from Mark.
Yeah, that one's too
just
low.
Just kidding. 1-1.
Didn't quite get across the plate in the zone.
So now the 1-1 here from Mars. That one outside, 2-1.
They're very yummy. They are yummy. I love
Mariners get their leads. 2-1.
2-2. Okay, we need you to hit a base hit. We need a hit. We need you to hit a triple.
So Evans steps in a 2-2 count. And Mars will step off.
And we need you to hit it down the left field line because that's 320 versus 280.
And that one. Look out.
Oh, coach.
It's down below your feet there, coach. There you go. You found it.
He may have to change his pants.
And so now 2-2 still to count.
Wind's right over there.
Wind's
right over there. Is Hershey going to win or is Wind going to win?
No. Well, look out.
Oh.
That one's behind him. Runners do not advance.
That's like the fourth or fifth one we've seen like that. It's not Twitter. It's X.
No, it's Twitter.
No
Nerds
Twitter.
Call it X.
There is no Twitter.
Nerds call it X.
If I, no. I am a nerd, but no.
I'm not calling it X.
Well, you should.
No. And that one. Low and away. Ball 4. Oh, no. Are we going to have another pitching change? So, timeout.
You know what I read earlier?
You read?
Jacobian said that the model is showing a cloudy day on April 8th.
Well, we know he's wrong. It's okay. Who? What did you just say?
I won't be outside on Wednesday.
You're talking about like north, right? Not here? You shut your mouth. You shut your mouth.
I won't be out here on Wednesday, so I don't care.
I don't care. What are we doing?
Well, Mother Nature's a bipolar, crazy person, so.
So after the intergalactic visit, Mars is ready to go. And he throws a strike.
I didn't realize that was Mars on the mound.
You think I'm just saying that the pitches are coming from Mars? Like,
have you been saying
yes.
that?
Yes.
I've not noticed you say that once until then.
Jeez. What's the count?
It's an 0-2.
So the 0-2 pitch from Mars.
Ooh.
Couldn't get him to chase. That one stayed around Venus.
Stop.
So
just stop.
Delusions, man. It reminds me. I got to get back home and watch the new season of For All Mankind, and that's strike 3. Beautiful pitch there from Mars for strike 3. And Cersei will leave the bases loaded, but they'll plate 4 more runs in the 5th. We'll head to the 6th with the Cersei Lions leading this one 13-5. back. I'm back. We're back. Here we are.
Back in the pocket last night.
Top six?
Top six. At most, two innings to go.
David Robertson.
I better not say that.
Not to be confused with Cy Robertson.
Okay, I'm done. Good night. Y'all have a good night. I'm going home.
Just go. Hey, do me a favor. Start pulling cameras. People can just listen. I don't know if that's a new pitcher. I have not been able to see the number. All right. So Figley is back out there. He misses on that one.
I'm back. I didn't go anywhere, but
that's right. you thought you was gonna leave.
I should.
You can't quit me.
Oh. You want to tempt me?
You've tried so many times.
God, I have.
You can't quit me, sir.
There have been so many times I've wanted to throw in the towel.
Every time I post on social media.
God, not only that, but anytime you have technical difficulties at your broadcast and you're texting me and calling me and stuff, I'm just like, oh, my God, just I'm done.
Ball.
If anybody up there this time of night,
they deserve it.
Yeah.
If you're in them woods right now, you can take that one and wear it.
I think we're off the rails now.
So
and the burnt rubber and all.
As long as it don't break.
Yeah, there is no broken rubber.
One, two. Oh boy.
Oh boy!
That ball lifted left field. I got to move a camera.
Yeah.
And left fielder, underneath it makes the catch. One away.
Sound like I'm coming from Mars.
Yeah,
you
Mars
are. Is coming in the
yes.
Perfect timing.
That was awesome.
I'm a Martian.
So Mars to the plate.
I've gone off the rails.
Let's go, Mars. Come on.
I'm off the rails.
Big fly. Put this one in orbit.
I thought you wanted to go home.
I want to see Mars in orbit.
Okay, shut up. Cy Mars.
I swear, if he hits a home run here, it's going to be so much fun.
He's not going to hit a home run.
Come on, Figley. 0-2.
See, he's in the hole now.
He's got him right where he wants him.
Yeah, that's
right
exactly
where
he wants him. Down 0-2.
That's right.
Okay.
He's going to golf this one right over the 360, son. You watch.
Okay. He doesn't need to golf it. He just needs to hit it over.
Well, because he's going to put this one low. That's why he's going to golf it. He's going to try to waste this pitch. He's going to make a mistake, and Mars is going to go down and get it, put it in orbit right over the 360 sign. Just kidding. Ball high, 1-2. I lost all my prediction powers after that basketball game that I predicted the final score in.
Huh?
You don't remember that? When the Valley View basketball game, when I predicted the actual final score.
Yeah.
And Andy lost his mind.
Well, the final score was the margin.
Well,
Said, you said we'd win by – or Mommel would win by 18.
Yeah. It was like a 9-point game. We were all freaking out. I was like, you know what's going to happen? Horns going to win this one by 18. What'd they do? Won by 18.
That was 2-2.
And Mars swings and misses. What are we doing? That's it's only two.
That's only one.
He's ready to go home too. I don't blame you, son. We're all ready.
Oh, he still got to score two runs.
I like it though. I'm with him. Cooper Thompson to the plate. Two away here.
Look, I don't care who. Wynn can come back and score 12 runs. With 12
runs. Do you know how long it would take them to score 12 runs? Would you be quiet?
12 runs still wouldn't win it.
Do you know how long it would take to score 12 runs?
Well, it took.
It'd be a whole other game. Be quiet.
It took Valley View.
That's different.
35 minutes.
Strike one. I think.
Yes.
Okay.
1-1.
All right. And Figley will step off, reset. Thompson steps back in there. Got the wiggle going. Strike two called.
Like the top of the next inning, are we all going to get up on that last out and start clapping?
Sure. I hope we don't go to the top of the next inning.
Oh, yeah. Touche.
That one low.
And like we say, it's not because we want one team to win or not. It's about getting home at this point because it's cold.
Because this chubby fella wants to run out there to center field, take our camera down, and get my butt home. And strike three called as Figley sits down Thompson. And that'll do it for the top half of the sixth. So after five and a half, Searcy leads this one 13-5. And did we call it? I think we called it. Ball game.
Oh.
Ball game. Ball game. Thank you. Thank you, everybody, for agreeing to make that happen. No more innings after 9 p.m. I don't know if that's what happened. All I know is it's over.
It's pretty good timing if it's not or if it is. So
that'll do it for this one. The Searcy Lions are victorious in the final game here of the Robinson Invitational, the 7th annual Robinson Invitational. And once again, we appreciate everybody for coming out, everybody here at the ballpark. I know Coach Delaney, the folks here at Robinson High School appreciate your patronage here over the last 3 days. I got to give huge credit to head coach Isaac Delaney and his team in putting this thing together. You guys have done a phenomenal job on this, and we appreciate all the hospitality. We appreciate you guys working with us and allowing us to be a part of this. And I hope you guys enjoyed the broadcast. And, hey, we got some summer ball. We need some broadcasting for. Feel free to reach out to us at Natural State Sports on social media. That is Natural State Sports, not Natty. Natural State Sports. You can call me 501-960-2255. Will, you can give your number, too, if you'd like.
Yeah, 501-620-9266.
There you go. For any sponsorships for our spring athletic events as well, but we are open to other events as we go through the summer. So, once again, we appreciate you guys for joining us. It's been a blast. We've had fun. For those of us here at Natural State Sports, Will Watkins, I'm Steve Henson. We'll see you on our next broadcast. Thanks for joining us. Have a good night.